那电影店在里面。右边有
Let's fix ample devices. I 1, 2, 3, H, N, minus 1. Then E is called is H 1 through H N minus 1 semi stable or stable. If along there for all non zero subject this kind of inequality, mu e, and this is defined by C1, chunk, the first chunk class type of C e times H1 to H n minus 1, which is integer. So, divided by rank of e. So this is an integer, so this is a irrational one. And of course, this is also defined, mu f is C1, and so on, divided by rank of f. And this is stable, means that always this inequality holds, mu f is smaller than and then, of course, this is well defined, and this is a very good notion. For example, if we have several famous results like this. First, if P is given, then there is a unique filtration. Semi-stable means this. This is semi-stable. It is given, there is a unique filtration. E as zero is E naught, and less than E one, and so on. Such that E divided by E n minus 1 is this set is there. I omit this one. If this is semi-stable, then there is some filtration. Filtration, not unique. Again, zero is E0, E1, and so on. Such that AK divided by AK minus 1 is stable. And this, so the sum of this greater factor is this is unique. This is unique up to isomorphism. So this is called the stable filtration. And the second property is that if there is some covering X dominant. The covering, that means a surjective morphism. Then F times pullback of E, if and assume that E is stateless symmetric. And assume that a characteristic of the field K is zero. Then pullback of E is again symmetric. This is an easy consequence of Galois. Galois theory plus the uniqueness of this non-Hermitian and then the next property is that existence of moduli space. So stable sheets vector modules. Modulo equivalence by isomorphic classes. That isomorphic classes of stable vector modules on a given X of with given chunk classes with C1 of E and C2 of E given. This is parameterized by a quasi-projective variety. This is the famous theorem of Giesecke. If you omit this standard condition, there is no such good penetration. And then, or if you give this is property, property. What kind of restriction? That says, if assume that E is stable, then so, or precisely written, if I say precisely, then this is H1, H minus 1, state, same state. Yes. And then there is a sequence of integers m1, m2, very big integers n minus 1, such that some member d1 in a linear system, M1, H1, and D2, something like that. So, such that the restriction of the vector bubble to the intersection, completed intersection, Dn minus 1, is a vector bubble on a curve, is again same state. It is easy to see that if the restriction of vector bundle is semi-stable, then the original vector bundle is semi-stable. But this says that the converse holds. So this was a group by Meyer and Damana. what is the property of semi-state or state rectangles over a curve? Then we have this as the following theorem. If E is a stable vector bundle over a curve, then there is some irreducible representation of pi 1 of C to unitary group of a rank A, rank of B is R. There is a representable irreducible representation such that E is induced by this representation. In particular, if C1 is zero, then B is flat. And of course, it is associated with the representation I want C to be SU R. So this has a flat connection. By definition, E minus zero, E star minus zero, a dual bundle minus zero section, divided by the C star, natural C star. And this is a projective bundle, P R minus one bundle, with the natural topological divisor. O1 as topological line bundle. Then what I want to say is that E is, oh sorry, no, sorry, this is just a little one, sorry. Then what I want to say is that E is semi-stable if and only if E is semi-stable if and only if this topological line bundle E is net. That means the following. This is limit of ample line bundle. This is simultaneously equivalent to say that E is, as a vector bundle, E is net. That means E times any ample divisor is H ample, is ample. Or more correctly, if you consider any covering C, so the dominant covering, F star E times H is angle for every angle divided by on C2. Angle over C. And this is equivalent to say that E star is net. So E and E star is both, both E and E star are a net. It's very strange, but this is true. Because this, this is not natural. It sounds unnatural, but it's not natural. It's natural because E is flat, essentially. And this proves that this equality proves that equivalence proves that if this says that if E is semi-stable, if and only if this is over C, semi-stable. If and only if symmetric piece of E is semi-stable. And for all covering, F star, for all covering, F star, E is semi-stable. I'd like to remind you that, sorry, I have to assume that in this case, characteristic of K is zero. And this also is zero. Okay. And from this observation, we had the following Gaudemont plane equation. X is for simplicity, I assume that X is a smooth surface, smooth protein. And let H be some angle divided. And assume that the vector bundle E is H stable, semi stable. Then you can combine the results I showed. Then you have the same quality. C1 of square of E is less than R minus 1, a rank R, so rank R. And this is at least T. Then C2 of E. This proves from the following Riemann-Roch theorem. This follows from Riemann-Roch theorem, which says that the symmetric tensor E of chi is essentially R plus 1 factorial divided by C2 of E minus this, oh sorry, 2R. R minus 1, 2R, C1 squared. Something's wrong. Sorry. 2R, R minus 1, C1 squared. Yeah. E. And by these observations, if E is semi-stable, minus R n by the observations, you can easily show that this is non-positive. This is non-positive, so that this. So this is a very simple observation, but this doesn't tell you what happens if the equal defaults. For that, but the following theorem says something about that. So, 6 centimeters. This was proved by, as you know, this theory was proved by Donaldson plus Uhlenbeck.
Yeah.
Integrability.
in down to earth terms, this is the following. Let C and A be a local vector bundle. Then I evaluate this with C and evaluate by eta is a homomorphism E and this again two endomorphisms. The interpretive condition says that these two are a community, a mutually commutative. So by elementary linear algebra, you can consider an eigen one form, a similar to this. Point wise, you can consider the simultaneous elementary linear eigen one form. Namely, there exists some covering x to the which is called a spectral minor. Such that the pullback so that if I induce the morphism from this is decomposed. This is decomposed like this. U1 SA S and one global one forms H mode X on X2. Phi restricted to EK minus omega one, omega K transferred with the identity. This is Newborn. When x is a curve, this e tilde is c tilde x tilde is called a spectral curve. You can consider the Higgs subshield. That means a subshield containing in F, which is preserved by this homomorphism, such that F is contained. And if you have a notion of Higgs subshield, then you have a stability, a notion of stability. That means E phi is stable or semi-stable. It's not zero Higgs function. We have the following input and input mu of f, which was defined by C1 minus f, H1 minus 1, of the rank is always smaller than mu. This notion of Higgs bundle was introduced by Simpson. The notion was introduced by Simpson. And he proved the following very model of Adorno's order of the alpha. And in a more general context, this was actually proved by the Mochi theorem. If E is, if E phi is stable, then that is essentially unique, but harmonic, that is harmonic and magnetic. Which is analog of the Einstein monopole. And this in particular says this, that force stable and semi-stable, but the Bogomov inequality holds. This topic to be defined as follows. Then, if you consider this Higgs bundle, then if X is original type, for simplicity, I assume dimensions. Actually, the argument. No, it's okay. Dimensions are nice. And assume that Kx is ample. Then you can easily prove that E pi is Kx n minus 1 times except state or semi-state. Then you can show that and the rank. This means that C2 of E is just C1 of C2 of omega x, and while C1 square, C1 E is just C1 of E omega x. So Simpson's inequality says the following. Rank is R plus 1, so C1, C1 square E, which is nothing but C1 square. Omega over k square, above it by so h1, and k, so kx n minus 2, and this is divided by kxn. This is smaller than n divided by I is n plus 1, and so this is twice. And this is just C1 of omega kx. And this is the famous Yellow's inequality. And if n is 2, then this is Bohm of Yellow. More elegant.